Coming up tonight, a look back at the Filipino Student Association's concert.
And with cell phone theft on the rise at UNF, find out ways you can keep your phone safe. That's all right here, right now, on your OTV News.
Good evening, Ospreys. I'm Kelly Lindstrom.
And I'm Connor Spielmaker. Welcome to your OTV News, powered by The Spinnaker. Someone in a red Mitsubishi is stealing phones from unsuspecting students at UNF, according to two similar UPD police reports this month. On January 7th, UNF student Andrew Thomas had his phone stolen from him by a man in a red vehicle. Just 4 days later, biology freshman Salah Azar reported a similar incident. Azar said two men in a red Mitsubishi 3000 GT approached him, asking to borrow a cell phone. He said the suspects claimed to be from FSCJ. Sergeant Dwayne Howard from UPD said similar descriptions from the victims means the same suspect may have committed the crimes.
We don't think they're students, but they're familiar with the university, of course, because they did it, I think, twice within 3 days. So they probably live in the area, and that's what we're probably thinking. They live in the area. They may even go to school in the area.
Howard encourages students to use any sort of GPS software provided on smartphones.
If you don't use the GPS or the cloud that they actually, the software that they've installed in the phone, then it's no help to you. So if the phone gets missing, we can't track it.
Azar also warns students not to give away anything they weren't willing to lose.
UNF nursing senior Thoy Tran and nursing junior Bianca Cabrera were recently elected as the first student officials to the Florida Nursing Students Association. The FNSA is an organization that helps prepare nursing students through the use of programs that correspond with current professional interest and concern. Tran held the recent position as 2011 Region 1 Director and Communications Chair and is now the 2012-2013 President.
When I joined, I know there are great benefits and, you know, like professional networking, but like I didn't realize that I kind of fell in love with it, being an advocate for nursing, you know, fighting for nursing professions and, you know, trying to resolve the issues that nursing are facing today.
As president, Tran is working to incorporate a program of total enrollment into lab fees for UNF nursing students. This would mean that any student entering the nursing program would be automatically enrolled in the FNSA with an option to opt out. Cabrera was elected Region 2 Director and Resolutions Chair. As director, she acts as a liaison between the state and local levels of the SNA. Resolutions Chair, her main goal is to create a second Southern chapter for the national level within the next 2 years. When asked why she ran for her position, Cabrera said, quote, "To be a nurse, you need to be a strong leader. You can't advocate for your patients if you're not. FNSA gives the tools you need to become a strong leader." Cece Aguilar is now here with us to let us know what kind of weather to expect for the upcoming weekend.
Thanks, Kelly. Hey, Ospreys, I'm Cece Aguilar, and this is your OTV weather forecast. We have seen no rain this week. Let's check out our precipitation maps to see if this beautiful weather will last into our weekend. Today, we have a 0% chance of rain. Tomorrow, that will start to change with about a 15% chance of rain during the day. Saturday, that chance of rain will continue to creep up with about a 20% chance of showers. And then on Sunday and Monday, we will see about a 10% chance of showers sometime before noon, disappearing into the weekend. Now let's take a look at our 5-day forecast. Today will be slightly warmer than the rest of the week with a high of 69 and a low tonight of 48 with a nice breeze. Tomorrow will be partly cloudy, keeping with those slightly warmer temperatures with a high of 68. Saturday, there will be a chance for showers with mostly cloudy skies and a high of 71. Sunday, we will start to see those colder temperatures moving back into the Jacksonville area with that rain from Saturday and a high around 64 and mostly sunny skies. And then on Monday, there will be mostly sunny skies as well with a high of 70. Most of the week's lows will be in the upper 40s and low 50s. Remember, for your latest updates on weather, check out OspreyTV.com. For your OTV News, I'm Cece Aguilar.
Gawad Kalinga means to give care in Tagalog, the language of the Philippines. It's also a nonprofit organization that aims to fight poverty in the Philippines. Along with Gawad Kalinga, UNS Filipino Student Association put on their fourth annual charity concert with 11 separate performances. Admission was free with a requested $10 donation. UNF FSA co-president PR junior Rodel Yanez and finance senior Patrick Lumang said their goal was not only to raise $2,500, but to shed light on poverty in the Philippines. UNF associate professor in mental health counseling Dr. Tess Tuajin has been the program advisor to UNF's chapter of the FSA for 7 years. Tuajin said, quote, "There is so much poverty in the Philippines that what the FSA is doing is really wonderful in terms of using resources here. The FSA surpassed its goal of raising $2,500, but would not disclose the exact amount."
UNF employees got into a dispute while they discussed scheduling issues. An officer met with two complainants who said the suspect pulled out a folding knife out of his pocket as the two sat back in their chairs, unaware of the suspect's intentions. They then questioned him about the knife, and he told them he uses it to read with. The complainants requested he put away the knife. The suspect looked at the knife, looked at the complainants, then put it away. At the request of the supervisor, the employer is no longer allowed on UNF property.
An officer met with a complainant who said her MacBook had been stolen. The complainant said she left her desk on the fourth floor in the library to go to the bathroom. When she came back, her laptop and charger were gone. The victim observed an unknown male acting suspiciously near her before the laptop was stolen. She could not provide a full description of the suspect. No one in the surrounding area saw anything unusual.
An officer met with a student that said she met another student during the first week of school, who then she exchanged numbers with. She gave the student a tour of UNF since it was his first semester. Since then, the suspect has continued to contact her and make her feel uncomfortable and nervous. She canceled a date with him, and he became very upset. He demanded to see her to give her some homemade sick tea at her dorm. She explained to him that she does not want to be in contact anymore. The officer contacted the suspect and requested to stop further contact. The suspect said he understands but has a lot of questions as to why. Rihanna Lindsay is now here with us to let us know what's going on in Jacksonville over the weekend.
Hey Ospreys, I'm Rihanna Lindsay with your Jax News. Now showing through Sunday, a little bit of magic is flying into Jacksonville with the Broadway show Mary Poppins, featuring the irresistible story and unforgettable songs from one of the most popular Disney films of all time, plus brand new breathtaking dance numbers. Mary Poppins guarantees you'll get swept up in the most delightful way. Ticket prices are $37 and up. To get your spoonful of sugar from this classic musical, visit artistseriesjax.org. If you're looking to capture a fun and free Friday night, come out to Hemming Plaza for the Photo Jax 2013 Street Party and Instagram viewing. As part of the Jacksonville Photography Festival, hashtag PhotoJax500 is a community response Instagram and Cinemagram project showcasing stunning hybrids between photo and video. Projections of Photo Jax submissions will begin showing at 7 p.m. You will not want to miss Borough Bar's local music showcase, also happening this Friday night. The lineup includes some of Jacksonville's finest indie rock bands, Art House, North, On Guard, and So Intense. The music starts at 8 p.m. and there's a $5 cover at the door. This Saturday, January 26th, the Museum of Contemporary Art launches its new exhibition, Slow, Marking Time in Photography and Film. It focuses on works that engage photography, film, and video to explore questions of time and duration, and it features artists whose approaches to this concept complement and challenge one another. The exhibit will run from the 26th until April 7th. Remember, MoCA is free for all UNF students with a valid ID. For more information, visit mocajacksonville.org. That's it for your Jax News tonight. Have a great weekend.
Thanks, Rihanna. Josh Brannick is with us now to give us your latest in the sports world.
Thanks, Connor. Hey Ospreys, I'm Josh Brannick here with your sports look ahead. The UNF men's basketball team will be on the road this weekend. Starting tonight, the Ospreys will be at USC Upstate at 7 p.m. On Saturday, the team will play against East Tennessee State University at 4 p.m. The Ospreys are coming off of a 77-68 loss to JU this past Friday. The team is currently in 7th place in the ASUN with a 3-4 conference record. The UNF women's basketball team will also be busy in the ASUN in the upcoming days. On Saturday, the team will face off against East Tennessee State University at ETSU at 1:30 p.m. On Monday, the team will play at USC Upstate at 5 p.m. The team is 4-3 in conference play, putting them in 4th place in the ASUN standings. The 63rd-ranked UNF men's tennis team will have its hands full this weekend as they play in the Intercollegiate Tennis Association's kickoff weekend. The team will begin play against number 1-ranked University of Virginia tomorrow at 6 p.m. On Saturday, the men will play either Auburn University or Georgia State. The event is being held in Charlottesville, Virginia. The UNF women's tennis team will be at home this weekend after a dominating performance at the FGCU invite this past weekend. The Ospreys will host Bethune-Cookman on Saturday, with matches beginning at 11 a.m. The matches will be played at the newly renovated tennis complex. The UNF swimming and diving team will be in action this weekend as they host Georgia Southern. The first event is scheduled for 1 p.m. at the UNF Aquatic Center. The team is 6-2 this year. And in other college sports news, the NCAA is holding off on any sanctions in the ongoing case with the University of Miami. The NCAA released a statement saying they have found what they believe is a, quote, severe issue of improper conduct. The issue stems back to evidence they used against Miami that was improperly obtained and related to a court case that had nothing to do with the university or the NCAA itself. All right, well, I'm going to make sure to look out for those that red Mitsubishi on campus from now on. So
absolutely. Sounds be safe. Like, hopefully they can catch them. I mean, I don't want someone to take my cell, but I don't think I would be like, oh, yeah, sure, you know, have fun.
Yeah, that does sound kind of weird.
Hold on to your cell phones, folks. Ospreys, that's all we have for you tonight.
Check us out anytime at OspreyTV.com or on Campus Channel 170. Have a fun and safe weekend, Ospreys.